Our big story this morning, a deadly four-alarm fire claims the life of a firefighter and sends several others to the hospital.
11 News reporter Jennifer Franciotti is live at the scene in Parkville with more details on the story. Good morning, Jen.
Good morning. 43-year-old Mark Falkenhan had a long career with the Baltimore County Fire Department, both as a career and a volunteer member. He was married and leaves behind a wife and two children and a fire community that's been rocked by this tragedy.
Fire service is a family, and this is when our people pull together.
An emotional Baltimore County Fire Chief John Homan talking about the death of one of his own. 43-year-old Mark Falkenhan was a member of the Lutherville Volunteer Fire Department. He was one of dozens of firefighters called to the scene of a four-alarm fire at the Towson's Crossings Apartments on Dowling Circle. Residents described the scene.
I know smoke was coming out of the building next to us. About 5 seconds later, this big ball of fire came right out the front door.
We went out up onto the balcony and we said, oh my gosh, it's, you know, the whole building's on fire. And it was from the bottom up all the way to the third floor.
They tried to get a big handle on this fire and they couldn't.
The fire started just after 6 Wednesday night. The initial call came in as a kitchen fire in the basement. Several residents were trapped inside. Chief Holman says Falkenhan got caught in a flashover.
Florida fire was too intense to make entry to start off with. They knocked the fire down. Crews went into the basement to fight the fire. And then crews went, as our practice is, went to the upper floors to see if there were any other victims. And then the flashover occurred.
And according to published reports this morning, Falkenhan's partner actually had to jump from the third floor. Falkenhan himself was found on the third floor balcony. He was taken to a local hospital where he later died. Two other people were injured in this fire, including one person who had severe burns. That person was taken to Johns Hopkins Bayview Burn Unit for treatment. Reporting live, Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.